I want you to understand sometimes God will stop your head from hurting so you can focus on the word to get the blessing you need for the week. Or God will show you how to deal with an annoying co-worker, give you that small miracle of peace in the office before he allows you to minister to their needs. Sometimes God will show you how to budget and tithe when you're making a little bit of money, because he gets ready to bless you with a promotion and a whole lot of money, and you need to know how to handle a whole lot of money. Amen. Come on. See, God will set you up with the preliminary before the main event. Anybody ready for God to do the main event in your life? Come on. You know, God. God got a main event miracle for you. Amen. God got a main event miracle for you. But you're going to need to learn how to fight for that thing. Can I tell you? Oh, God, I know I got some boxing fans in here somewhere. Amen. You know, amen, when you make it to the main event, you ain't fighting the tomato cans no more. You ain't fighting. Amen. They're also rans. The guys that been out there fighting, they about 45, 50 years old, can't hardly swing no more. When you get to the main event, you fight the crumbs. Then the crumb, you fight the Floyd Mayweather, amen. You fight the Manny Pacquiao, amen. Somebody that can put a whoop upside your head, amen. But if you don't get to the main event miracle, then it's the same thing. You ain't praying for a headache no more. You ain't praying for 50 cents to buy a bag of chips no more. You believe in God for something big, something spectacular. You need to God to do something right now. Anybody need God to do something big? Do something big in your life right now. Can I tell you, that's a main event miracle. And when you get to the main event, you can't come half stepping. Come on, somebody. You got to understand how to fight for your miracle. Amen. Can I give you three things before I go home? I'm going to go home real quick too. Amen. I'm going to give you three things to let you understand how to fight for your miracle. Amen. First thing you need motivation. Amen. See, you got to be some motivation. Amen. To seek God for a miracle. See, sometimes when you don't need nothing, you don't ask for nothing. And I'm not going to tell a lie. We are of a people that when everything is going well, then we got a lazy, fat attitude. Amen. We just as nonchalant about everything. And I won't tell a lie. I get like that too. I give God my praise, but every now and then, if I don't need nothing, my praise ain't as intense. Amen. I'm just telling the truth to shame the devil. When everything is going well, my belly is full. It's full. House is warm. Gas in the car. A little bit of change in the bank. I don't pray so hard, amen. Sometimes I need motivation for the main event. Can I tell you, but when things get rough, amen, and things get tough, and the hills get so hard to climb, well, I find my way to my knees. I find my way just to get a little extra prayer time in the morning. I get up a little bit earlier. I read my Bible just a little longer. I talk to God just a little bit more. Why? Because I'm motivated, because I need thee, God. I'm going to tell you, I'm just telling the truth. Y'all ain't clapping for me, but that's all right. Some of y'all know I just came down your street. Amen. How many of you motivated right now? You might not be as motivated as you need to be, but I thank God that God ain't always keeping score. Amen. God understands the human condition, and sometimes he realizes that we need a little trouble on our way to make us come running back to him. Come on. Can I tell you right now, you need a motivation. If you look at the 8th verse, you see these simple words. And then Amalek came. Then came Amalek. Let me tell you about Amalek. Amen. As a motivation, it couldn't have been nobody but Amalek was a warrior, amen, who didn't mind fighting, loved to fight. The thing about Amalek, amen, he didn't fight fair. And see, Amalek would not come at you like a man and get in your face and tell you what he wanted to do with you, amen. He would sneak around the back. He would attack your men, your little boys and your little girls and your old women and your old men. He would attack them. He would attack them from the back. He would attack them and cause you to have to turn around and go back to fight because you had to protect the little ones. He would never fight nobody that could fight back. It was motivation for the children of Israel to look for a miracle, because look, Amalek was a fighting man, and they ain't know how to fight. Amen. It was a motivation for a miracle, because look, these were people that had never fought before. Remember, they had just came out of slavery. They needed a motivation to fight. They had just come through, they had just embarked into the wilderness. They needed a motivation to fight. Their first battle that they ever had, they didn't fight it, God did. They didn't have to do nothing. They needed motivation to fight. And look, what better motivation than when somebody messed with your babies? Come on. It's a mother in here today that came here to see their baby singing and to give God some praise. I guarantee you right now, if someone were to come out to one of your babies right now, you see an angry mama or an angry daddy up in this place. You'll see some motivation, amen. Well, let me tell you, that was the motivation that the children of Israel had, that Amalek came. And when Amalek came, it caused them to want to be able to protect them, to protect their ones that they love. And in the midst of wanting to protect them, they were challenged in a way that they had never been challenged before. See, they had to learn how to fight for their miracle. See, they was waiting on to see what God would do, but God was waiting on them to get motivated. Do you realize that sometimes God knows he can fix a problem for you? They can split just like that. But God is waiting on you to see how motivated you are to get your own miracle. Come on. Sometimes we sit back and we wait on God, sit on a seat of do nothing, believe it all the time, yes, and hoping. But is that spirituality or is that just laziness? Amen. Are you so used to God saving you all the time that you ain't making no attempt to work it out for yourself, to get up, to go do something, to go learn something, to go see something, to go be something? Amen. In the name of Jesus. But if you get up in the name of Jesus, can I tell you right now, if you get up in the name of Jesus, good things about to happen. Amen. Come on. Anybody believe that God is getting ready to do something great? God is getting ready to do something mighty in your life. All you got to do to get to your main event miracle, what? Is to start by being motivated. Come on. Somebody say motivated. All right. Somebody say fight for your miracle. Come on. The next thing I'll tell you today, that in this fight for your miracle, you got to learn to see and hear the revelation of God. Let me tell you right now, the revelation of God is mighty. The revelation of God begins to put things in your ear. Amen. And I tell you, you can't hear God and see God and move for God unless you're receiving revelation knowledge from God. The Bible said that it is a responsibility and a requirement to be the sheep of God. You have to hear his voice. Amen. You have to know his voice, and you have to be willing to follow his voice. That's a requirement to be a sheep of God and to get a miracle from God. Watch this. In verses 9 and 10, this is the revelation. See, they got the motivation. The enemy is attacking them. Amen. Now the revelation is this, and it came through Moses. In verse 9, he said to Joshua, this is what the Lord told him, go choose out some men that are willing to fight. Amen. And go fight Amalek. And that's the revelation. The revelation is, it's time to fight. Amen. Come on. Some of y'all might not want to hear it's time to fight. Some of y'all want to hear it's time to line up and get it. Some of y'all want to hear it's time to sit down and somebody going to bring it to you. Some of y'all don't want to hear that you better get up and do something. But can I tell you a word from God? If you're looking for a main event miracle, then it's time to fight. Amen. That was the revelation, that you got to get up and go fight. Amen. You got to fight for your miracle. You can't wait for your miracle. You can't hope for your miracle. You can keep on praying for your miracle, yes, but you got to go do something. Amen. You might have to do something you ain't never done before. Maybe you ain't never done it like that. Maybe you ain't never seen it like that. But when God is revealing to you his brand new plan within, it might be something you ain't never seen before. But you better understand and know the voice of the Lord. Lord. Because when you know the voice of the Lord, it makes the going easy. Amen. It's easy to go when you hear the voice. Peter heard the voice of Jesus. He saw an image. He saw an image coming to him on the water. The water, the image made him afraid. Amen. It was the image that caused everybody in the boat to be afraid. But Peter said, if it be thee, O Lord, bid me to come. And all Jesus said, but that raging sea, when the water was coming over the boat, when the storm was up high, Jesus just said, come. Peter recognized the voice and got off the boat. Can I tell somebody here today? Can I preach to somebody? I got to look all around the room because I really, God ain't told me right now who I'm talking to. But can I tell somebody, you better hear the Lord's voice today. The Lord is telling you to fight. You need a miracle. You need a healing. You need deliverance. God is telling you to fight, fight, fight. You got to get up and you got to get ready to rock and roll, amen, to get the job done. That's what God ain't got you all by yourself. Watch this. When the revelation comes, God ain't got you by yourself. Look, the fighting for the miracle was not going to be done just by Moses. It was not going to be done just by Joshua. It was not going to be done just by the men. But it was going to be a collective effort. Because the miracle was too big for one person to get. Oh God, the miracle is too big to get by yourself. You got to understand that it's somebody else that's going on the same road that you're going. Maybe they don't need your exact miracle, but you can get a prayer partner or two. Amen. Somebody to walk through with. Somebody to go ahead and say, God, they got the same revelation that I got. You say it's time to fight. I know I'm not the only one that believes it's the time. It's time to fight here at Goodwill. I'm not the only one that think that it's time to fight at Goodwill. I'm not the only one that's tired. I don't mind being in the wilderness. I don't mind if God led me to the wilderness, but I'm sick and tired of being the devil's punching bag. I'm sick and tired of being the devil's sick and tired of the devil attacking me on everything inside. I'm sick and tired of him getting at my children, getting at my grandchildren, messing around on my child, messing with my money, messing with my bank account. I'm sick and tired of the devil messing with my church. Amen. I'm tired, and I don't mind being in the wilderness, but I understand in the wilderness, it's time to fight. I need some miracles. I need some healing. I need some blessing. Am I by myself up in here? It's time to fight.
Yes.
It's time to fight.
Yes.
Okay, I say it one more time. It's time to fight.
Yes.
God said, choose a folk.
Yes.
God is saying it right now. God is saying, choose a folk, Pastor. Choose some folk. Look at some folk. Look at some folk, God. See, God is going to identify you by the word of God. Let me go off the sermon just for a minute. God is going to identify you by the word. Because see, them that can get the word, them that will accept the word, them that hunger and thirst after the word, them are those that are going to get the revelation that it's time to fight. There's going to be some here that are going to get a blessing just because they hung around long enough. You hang around long enough and you might get the residue. But I don't want the residue or nothing. I don't mind God giving me the residue if I can't do no better than that. But if I got the unction and the gumption and the wherewithal to hear what the word of the Lord is saying, and if God is revealing that it's time to fight, well, sign me up for the Christian Jubilee. Right my hand on the roll, because I'm getting ready to rock and roll and get the take. Come on, somebody got to realize that it's time to fight. God said, choose. Look, and as you choose, God is going to anoint them that he chooses. Come on, you got to understand the fight is about to go down in Goodwill, and God is going to anoint them that he chooses. And if you are chosen by God, then you're going to be equipped for the fight. The fight is not for the faint, it is not for the weak, it is not for the feeble of spirit. You might not be quick and swift on your feet, but boy, if you know how to get a prayer through, you can be on my team. Amen. I'm going to tell you, the fight for the spiritually strong, them that are committed to God and all their ways. God said, choose some folk that will fight. Amen. Because you got to learn how to fight for your miracle. Come on, somebody. Give God a praise right there. This is the last thing I'm going to tell you. The last thing I want to tell you, you got the motivation, amen. You got the revelation, amen. Now you need to get down with the implementation. Let me make it clear to you. Be motivated for a moment. Having the revelation come to you in an instant is good. But what good is it if you don't do anything? You got to do something. You can't just talk of it, Paul. You got to be a part.
That's right.
Oh, God. Let that be a word that resonates in your soul.
Yeah.
You know, you've been in this church long enough. And see that there are things we need, and things we must have,
all right,
and things that we should have, and places where we could go, and places where we should go. Don't wait for nobody to tell you to get up and do something. You find what it got your hand to do, and you go start doing. You go get with your pastor. You go get with your leaders. You tell them what your idea is. You begin to work. And if they can't nobody get with your idea, there's a ministry for you on the outside of these walls anyway. You got to get out and take the word of God. But you got to do something. You got to move so folk can see that you got something going on. It's called implementation. Don't come in here every Sunday and get fed off this word I'm preaching to you, and then you don't go give nobody none of this. Come on. You got to give somebody some of this. And if you don't give somebody some of all this word I've been giving you, you're going to get fat as a tick. Ain't good for nothing. Amen. You need to go give it out. Amen. Go run up and down the street somewhere. Tell somebody about the goodness of God. This church ought to be running over. You know what? Because everyone ought to bring one. Come on, somebody. We can bring one if we get committed to God. We got to implement this thing. Watch this, y'all. Moses gave them, they had the motivation. Moses gave them the revelation. And then guess what Moses did? Moses went on up to the hill. And he took Aaron and Hur with him. Joshua went on down to the valley. And they began to fight with Amalek. And let me tell you, as they began to put it into order, they took the plan of God and they began to implement the plan of God. Can I tell you, the plan of God was that Moses go to the top of the hill and he take the rod or the anointing of God with him, and he lift the anointing, the rod of God, up to the heavens, and Joshua was to go and start fighting. You didn't wait for Moses to holler. You just went on the word of the Lord, and you saw the plan of God being implemented, and you went to town. And the Bible let me know that Joshua and the children of Israel were winning. As long as Moses had his hand in the air, they were winning. But you know what? As long as Moses had his hand in the air, he was bound to get tired. And I know a whole lot of people preach this text right here, how he got tired and his hands drooped down. And yes, that's a good point, but I'm going to tell you, I'm going to go a little deeper than that. But look, while he was there, he didn't come alone. He brought some folk with him. Yes, amen. He brought Aaron and Hur. They were there. Look, sometimes you do need to have some folk that understand your vision. Amen. They understand the revelation that God has given you. They understand what it is to fight for a miracle. And when Aaron and Hur saw Moses' hands going down, they didn't wait to say, what can we do for you, brother pastor? How can we help you, brother pastor? What's wrong with you, brother pastor? You ain't fired up as you was, brother pastor. You ain't preaching good like you was, brother pastor. They didn't wait. They tell me they did two things. You know, they went and got a stone for them to sit on. And then they stood on one side, and one stood on the other side, and they held up his hands. And can I tell you, it's good to have somebody that know how to fight with you, to understand what it takes for the anointing to flow, and understand what it takes for God to move. But a whole lot of folk, when they preach this, that's the only part they get to, that he got to help from Aaron and Hur. But I'm here to tell you, can I take it just a little bit deeper for you this morning? Before I go to my seat, they did something, that really ensured the victory in the battle. Because can I tell you, fast forward, as long as they kept up Moses' hands, the children of Israel won the battle. They won. They whipped the devil. They got their miracle. And a whole lot of people, they attribute it to the fact that Aaron and Hur were there holding up Moses' hand. But I got another character in the story. You know Moses, you know Joshua, you know Aaron, and you know Hur. But can I introduce you to the stone? Can I introduce you to the stone that the builders rejected? Or can I introduce you to the chief stone of the corner? Because the Bible tells me that they brought a stone and they set it down on the hill, on a hill far away. They tell me they set the stone down on the hill and Moses set on the stone. Some of y'all ain't getting with me. That's all right. Maybe if I tell you like this, it was a stone, but another name for a stone is a rock. Come on, somebody. Y'all ain't getting with me. The rock that Moses stood. It was the rock that Moses set on. It was the rock. You might know that rock as the rose of Sharon. You might know that rock as the lily of the valley. You might know that rock as the bright morning star. You might know that rock as the farm in Gilead. You might know that rock as Mary's baby, the son of God. But I know that rock. I know that rock anywhere. If I get my miracle, I got to go to the rock. Oh, who do you turn to? There's nobody left to listen. I'm going to fight for my miracle. I know I need the rock. That rock is Jesus, and he's the one. That rock is Jesus, he's the only one. So be sure, be very sure. Come on, somebody. If you want to fight for your miracle, you better learn to be sure. Be very sure that your ankle holds. Your ankle grips a solid rock. That rock is Jesus. Can I tell you to get here? If you will ever learn to fight for your miracle, yes, you need motivation. Yes, you need revelation. Yes, you need implementation. But you also need that rock. You need to rest in the rock. You need to live on the rock. You need to be blessed by the rock. You need to trust in the rock. You need to go to the rock. You need to be in the rock. You need to stay with the rock. You need to roll with the rock. Come on, somebody. Get to your feet. Are you ready to get down with the rock? I don't mean to stop, get it. Are you ready to roll? Rock with it. You ready to roll? Roll with it. The Jesus is the rock. He is the rock of ages. He is the rock in the wilderness land. He is the rock that will see you through to your miracle. You ready to fight? The heap was ready to fight. The rock was ready to go to the cross. The rock was ready to die. The rock was ready to be raised again. The rock did get up. On the third day, the rock rose. The rock rose without power in his hand. The rock still lives. The rock is on the right hand of God. The rock is making intercession for you. The rock is here today. Do you